Every girl dreamt that she wants to join the army and grew up with that dream in her mind. Whether she finally lands up or not, half the battle would have been won and the country would be amazing. I visited the Armed Forces Medical College and I could see a sense of discipline, a sense of, you know, where there was an opportunity to have all-round development. When I met the students there, it was not only about books. So I thought I should have fun becoming a doctor. And that discipline and that, you know, everything spits, polish and spick and span really impressed me. And I'd also met my husband. So he was also from NDA. And was going to join the armed forces. So that made up my mind that this is what I want to do. Yes, it was the day I wore my uniform. As was the first batch we had a passing out parade. It was on exactly 27 December 1982. It was an amazing feeling to have that time just two stars on the shoulder. But you suddenly felt elevated and different. So the first and foremost is a woman who has a strong heart. I mean, who's not going to be bogged down by difficulties, who knows how to rise. If there's a tough thing, if she falls, she'll just get up and continue. That's one. But at the same time, there's also a woman, a mother, a sister, a daughter, a wife. That aspect is also there. And third is a person who's a professional, but also has time for herself to keep herself fit in mind and body and follow her hobbies. I think the biggest myth of women joining the army is they treat that there must be something, you know, different and how do they manage. But when you actually join, it's your competence. I don't think gender makes such a difference once you join. As an organization, there is no difference made between men and women. It's you're competent or you're not competent. The second myth was when we joined. I mean, at that time we were not, but everyone was, I'm immediately going to be at the border and just start fighting the enemies. So it's not that. That's not the only aspect. You're leading men, you're leading a team. There's so much more that you're doing as a professional. To girls young, not just five, at any age, I think you need to learn to dream. And then I think once you have a dream and you have a focused vision, you strive towards it. So just, even if you then don't join, land up joining the armed forces, the fact that you've had a dream, I think, and make sure that the girl already is thinking of something which is fit, which is, you know, disciplined, even that's going to change the whole nation.